Hey, this is TerraToots with an introduction to using shaders to color terrain in TerraGen. They can also be used to control other properties, such as luminance and reflectivity, but for now, we'll focus on colors. If you open the default scene and switch to the Shader tab, you'll notice that your terrain already has a shader applied. This Base Colors shader is automatically created when the world is, and defaults to a mix of gray and black. Useful, but rather boring. Let's take a look at how to add some color to our world. First, click Add Layer, then Surface Layer. Surface layers are very versatile, and by layering several of them, you can build up a realistic-looking surface color. By default, our new surface layer comes out as a grayish-white color, covering the entire terrain. We can change the color by clicking this small square here. Let's go ahead and choose a brown color. You'll see the preview update with our new color. Now, in most cases, you won't want just a single plain color. To make things more realistic, we can add some variation to our brown by adding a color function. Click this green plus mark here, then create new shader, color shader, and then power fractal shader. You'll see that our brown now has lighter and darker patches. If we don't want our new color to cover the entire terrain, we can use the coverage slider here. Let's move the coverage down to around 0.5. And now we can see the base color is starting to show through our brown layer. If we want to, we can use the fractal breakup slider to increase the contrast of our surface layer, or reduce it to blur the edges of our brown color and blend it a little better. In the next video, we'll cover how to use altitude and slope constraints to control where our colors are painted on the world.